It was a heck of a ride. I lived a good life. I fought a good fight. And I want you to know it was hard to let go until I saw the light. The Lord called my name. Angels came and took me by the hand. We flew to heaven.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to start the service with a prayer at this time. Please take your seats. Pastor Spencer is going to approach the speaker here. He's going to say the opening prayer. Then the honor guard will start the military portion of the service. And after that, we'll start the memorial service after the honor guard. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm very glad to be here this morning. I apologize to any of you that had trouble getting through on the cutoff. That was my gray van in the side of the tanker truck. So, but I made it anyway, so I'm glad to be here. Let's bow our heads in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for Mr. Craighead today. We're here to honor his life. We're thankful for everyone that's here. We ask today that you would bring us comfort and peace, settle every heart, every mind, and just give us a great day. And we thank you for it in the name of your lovely Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here today to render final military honors to a fallen soldier. Today's honors will consist of the plane of taps, the unfolding, refolding, and presentation of the flag. We ask of those who are sitting, if you're physically able, to please stand during the plane of taps. All current and former service members, please render their proper hand salute. The civilian hand salute is the right hand over the heart. Thank you. If you're physically able, please stand.
Thank you.
accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for these arguments.
Sidney King Craighead was born in Oakland, California on April 27, 1937. He graduated from Fresno High School in 1955. He attended college at Fresno City College, California State University, Fresno, University of California, Santa Barbara, California State University, Hayward, and the University of Southern California. He earned his Bachelor's of Business Administration with a minor in Biology from the California State University in Fresno in 1964. Sidney and Mary were married on July 17, 1972. They celebrated 43 years of marriage before she passed away in 2015. Their children include Susan Lynn Craighead Martinez from Sid's prior marriage, and Richard Lindsay and Stephen Lindsay from Mary's prior marriage. During his 31 years of his teaching career, he taught at Dianuba High School, El Dorado High School in Placerville, and Avenal High School. He also partnered with his father and brother in a family business, California Crane Brokers. After the business was sold, Sid returned to teaching high school. He retired from Reef Sunset Unified School District in 2007. He was active for many years in community politics and dozens of economic projects. He was a longtime City of Avenal council member and served as mayor from 2004 to 2006. He was on the planning commission here in town, city council member, a member of LAFCO, the local agency for formation commission, the Kings County Association of Governments, the Kings County Area Public Transit, Kings Area Rural Transit, along with the California League of Cities, the Ambulance Commission, Blueprint for Fresno County, and San Joaquin Valley. And he was a busy gentleman. He was involved with the Rotary, Everett Avenel, Fresno Trail Club, Las Palmas, Ponderosa, New Masonic Lodge, Fresno Scottish Rites, the Tehran Shrine Temple, Tehran Temple Guard, and Kings County Shrine Club. He was predeceased in this life by his parents, Porter King and Bessie Craighead, his brothers, James Anderson and Robert Anderson, his sister, Lucinda Craighead, his wife, Mary, and his daughter, Susan Lynn. He's survived by today his stepsons, Richard Lindsay, and his wife, Shirley, Stephen Lindsay, and his wife, Laura, six grandchildren and seven great-grandchildren, and a host of other relatives and friends. My son Dale's coming to sing.
Up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm, there's a golden sky and the sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown, Walk on, walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. When you walk through the storm, hold your head up high. Don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm, there's a golden sky, and a sweet silver song of the Lord. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Walk on, with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. No, you'll never walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Walk on, walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. You'll never
in the book of Acts, we find these words spoken by the Apostle Paul. He says, remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. And in speaking with different people from the community here and family, I felt that this scripture reflected the life of Sid Craighead. He constantly was giving. Now, I noticed that he had a lot of education. And so if you want to give a lot, you got to know a lot. And he spent a lot of time and gathered a lot of knowledge and put effort into his own education and did those things which you must do if you're going to help others around you. Somebody said he was quite a visionary, almost to the point that when he was mayor, his ideas were sometimes way out there. But he did always, as well as having vision, being a visionary, he always kept his feet on the ground. Because he was always teaching, and his teaching, many of the things that he taught were the practical things in life. He taught economics. I had a young lady in my church said that he taught her how to reconcile a checkbook. Another guy said, well, he taught us how to dabble in the stock market. they had to have, they had to beat, pick their stocks and their imaginary, bought some imaginary stocks and watch it for a few days, see which way it went. So although, you know, he had lofty ideas, you know what, you gotta have a lot of lofty ideas if you're gonna pull off even a few small ideas. Because out of every lofty one, the man sitting next to you may pick out the thing in it that's gonna work for the community of Avenal. Talk to his stepson, Steve. And we talked a little bit, and one thing that stuck with me, he said, well, you know, he never really tried to take the place of my dad. I said, but he was always there for me. Always there for me. And that shows some wisdom, that he didn't try to take a place that wasn't his. And, you know, he put a lot of effort in for the city of Avenal, spent some time as mayor. Just being a pastor here can be a daunting job. Just imagine if you're trying to come up for the welfare of the whole community. And he took time, and he spent time. And I met him on several occasions. A few years back, he called me, and he had a relative that was in a little bit of trouble and considered sending him to school in Riverdale, to Riverdale Christian Academy. So he was involved in lives. He was involved in lives as family, the family members. He was involved in community. And I heard a story about a young lady who lives in this community now. When she was in high school, she got herself in a bit of trouble. In fact, she got sent out of Avenal High School and was sent to the continuation school. And she got her act back together, and she came to the principal and said, I'd like to get back in school. And they said, well, you've got to go talk to every teacher and see if they'll allow you back into their classroom. She went to every teacher, and every teacher, with the exception of one, said, no, you cannot come back to my class. But the one teacher who said, yes, I'll take you back, was Mr. Sid Craighead. And as she told the story with tears in her eyes, she said, that was a turning point for me. Hey, kids are fun. I'm the principal of a Christian school in Riverdale with 150 kids. What they can't dream up in a day can't be dreamed up. So dealing with students for all those years and still coming out with a positive and good attitude about what's going on in this community, in this world, is a tribute to a person and a personality. I see some of you here that have been involved in the school system, teachers. I see you here that were involved in the political area. And you're here today. I see his family here. We're here because a man touched our hearts, our lives, and made a difference for us. If he doesn't make a difference, we don't come. But that's why you're here today, because somebody, and this man in particular, Mr. Sidney King Craighead, made a difference in hearts and lives. You know, our Savior looked at it and said he stood over his city, and he looked down and said he wept. The scripture in the Bible, the shortest one, John 11:35, said Jesus wept. Why was he weeping? Because he looked over his city and he saw all the issues and all the problems and all the struggles. And Jesus, as our Savior, was able to do a lot more than Mr. Sid Craighead, but Mr. Craighead did what he could do. He got involved. He didn't walk away. He didn't say there's too much trouble. He didn't say it's not worth my time and effort. He didn't say forget them, I can retire now and take my leisure. He looked like he was busier after he retired than when before. Running for political office, being involved in city planning and county planning and roadways. All those kind of things takes time and effort. But he was willing to do it because whenever he looked over this city, he felt like Avenal was his city and a place where he needed to have an impact. And you know what? I'm going to talk to you today. Let somebody here take up that mantle and have a concern for our city. There's a lot of needs here in Avenal, California. Are you doing what you can do to make a difference? Now I see some of you say, I'm off the hook because I don't live in Avenal. And you were saying, no, you're here. But I'm going to talk to you. I don't know where all of you live. I know these folks live in Clovis. You may live somewhere else. Are you doing everything you can do in your community to make a difference? Are you reaching out? Are you filling posts that are empty? Are you trying to make a difference in a world that needs people that are willing to make a difference? I hope that you are today, because I believe that's what Sid did. He made a difference anywhere he could. Did he make everything perfect? No, but he kept fighting the battle, kept working for me, and kept working for you as long as he was able. Now, you and I can go no farther. We will never get to meet him again here on this life. But I'll tell you what, I'm going to encourage you. My example today for this was Jesus Christ, that he loved his community, that he cared for others, that he taught us it was more blessed to give than receive. And if you don't know Jesus as your personal Savior today, I want to encourage you to consider him. He can make the biggest difference in a life, even a bigger difference than Mr. Craighead made. And you don't want to miss this opportunity. Dale's going to come back, and he's going to do it without the warbly music this time.
Let's sing this song together.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace that brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun. We've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun, than when we first begun.
The family appreciates each and every one of you that came today, and we have a meal prepared here. And we want to encourage everyone to stick around. And after the meal, then we're going to open up. Some of you can tell your Sid Craighead story. All right? So don't be in a rush. We're going to have a good time of fellowship together. And right now, I believe I can go ahead and ask a blessing on the meal, right? All right. Let's bow our heads together. Heavenly Father, we thank you again for this day and this time and the people that are gathered here together. We ask for peace and joy and healing in every heart and every life. We thank you for a meal that was prepared by this community. Bless the hands that prepared it and sanctify it to the purpose in our bodies. We thank you for all you've done. And we give you the glory and the honor and the praise in the name of Jesus. Amen. And who's in charge of the meal? Going to do the directing. Just to be you're ready. Okay. So I would assume we can let the family.
I'm on my way to
peace. Walking on streets of gold, marveling at the wonder and the beauty of it all. No more trials or tribulations. My soul has been set free. This place is indescribable. I'm happy as can be. Goodbye, it's not forever.